electronics and communication, and he is actually a postgraduate in computer applications. So he started his career from industry, and he was working in Stargate computer systems in Calicut. So then after that, he was with Calicut University in the MCA department as a faculty. And from there, he has, after working there for 3 years, he has joined Chinmaya Institute of Technology as assistant professor. He was working there for 5 years. Then he joined government service, and he's in the post of computer programmer. See, this post of computer program is equivalent to a software administrator or system administrator post, remnant of the whole thing. They have not changed the name of the post. The post is still called as computer programmer, but it's basically network administrator, system administrator is the job that they are doing. Okay, so he is the system administrator of government engineering college. He joined, he was there in Wayanad also, government engineering college Wayanad, and he was there for 4.5 years. Presently, he is with Kannur, Kannur Government Engineering College, Kannur. Almost around 15 years of experience, research experience, 3 years of research experience, 15 years of teaching experience, and all those things are there. He holds certifications also. He is domain expertise in computer networks, network security, open source software, etc. He is a Red Hat certified system engineer, that is RHCSC, and he is having RHCE also, Red Hat certified engineer. CCNA, S&R, Cisco certification is also there for him. And he is an ethical hacker too. He's having wide experience in conducting workshops. Here also he has come 2 or 3 times. We have not met the other day. I was talking about this because he told that he had come here 2 or 3 times. And I asked my faculty, and they told he has come for taking classes in computer science, for even workshops as well as faculty development programs in computer science department he has come to. So we are very happy to have you here, sir. And this particular point also, this particular topic also is very interesting, because we are going to talk about Moodle LMS system. Then, you know, the from the discussions that we had on the other day, if any one of the people are not having, I mean, any one of the professors are not having working LMS system, they can adopt this system, and you have promised that you will be helping them to set up the system on remote assistance. We are very happy to have you here, sir. So over to you, sir. Welcome, and over to you, sir. Binish, sir, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I hope I am audible now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. A very good evening to all. I hope all of you have got the presentation which I shared with you, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, it's okay. A WhatsApp group.
Okay. Thank you. So I can give you. We can go directly to the presentation, because we have time limitation. So can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, as all of you might be knowing, this Moodle is an open source course management system. I think all of you are very much familiar with this Google Meet or Zoom meeting, right? It's an online platform to conduct the classes, right? So whereas
yes,
this Moodle, we cannot compare it with our Zoom or Google Meet. It's a totally different system. Okay, this Moodle is a course management system. We can call it as a CMS, or we can call it as an LMS, a learning management system, or even we can call it as a virtual learning environment. This is the basic thing. Is this Moodle is not a platform for conducting the online classes, but instead what it is it's a learning management software or learning management system which can used for the teaching learning process. Instead of taking classes online through as we are taking it through what you call that Google Meet or Zoom, this Moodle is an entirely different thing, which we can call it as a course management system or a learning management system or virtual learning environment or VLE. Okay, it stands for this modular object oriented dynamic learning environment. Okay, it's we have a lot of proprietary software or commercial softwares available for that. This Moodle is what I can call it as, it's the one of the best solution for that, and it's available in open source also. You need not pay anything for make use of this Moodle services. Is totally free, and we can customize the entire Moodle application as we wish. And it is having used in almost 208 countries and 75 in, it's available in 75 languages. So all these are some basic details about Moodle. Why we are using, or for what purposes are we are using this Moodle? As I told you, it is not an tool for conducting this online classes. Instead, it is a device, or it is a tool which will help us to organize the teaching learning processes. Okay, so what we can do is we can have this online elements or ready courses, deliver completely online courses. We can deliver, we can communicate, we can assess, we can manage the course contents. So we can upload the files, we can upload or connect the resources, external resources. If we have some sort of audio files or video files or image files, or even some sort of references files. So whatever things, if you are having that you are having with your in connection with a particular topic, everything can be organized in a single point. In single place, which will be accessible to the participants of that particular course. So basically what we are doing, or how we are doing this Moodle, is in Moodle we are creating different courses. Okay, and in courses what we can do is we can have different kinds of participants. There will be teachers, there will be teaching assistants, assistants will be there will be students. So there are different kinds of users are going to access these contents. So teachers are having all the rights, full rights to create the content, create the resources, create the whatever things what we are having, like that we are having to conduct the sessions. So all those things can be uploaded and stored in the Moodle server. Okay, so for this particular students, or for each of this, both students and teachers are having their own user IDs and passwords. When students log into this Moodle server, they can see whatever things you, as a teacher, whatever things you are uploaded to that site, everything will be visible to that student. And the most important thing is you can access this server from the campus or outside the campus. So everywhere it is available. If you are making, if you are configuring your server in such a way that it is available in intranet as well as internet, both in both way we can configure it. We can just see it. Okay, so we can create the environments and it is easily manageable. We can create chat modules where in a class we can conduct different chats, we can give discussion forums, we can give assignments, whatever things we want to, as a part of our teaching learning process, each and everything can be incorporated to Moodle. Okay, so these are the basic features. As a teacher, most of the time we have to give assignments to the students. There is provision for providing assignments. There is provision for chat rooms. So on different topics, if we want to conduct the classes, we can chat rooms are available. There is a provision for choice for conducting the polls or opinion poll, something like that. So those kind of choices are there. Dialogues, in the sense, it is a one-to-one asynchronous message exchange, something like a similar kind of chat on a particular topic. If we want to discuss something, we can do it using dialogues. Discussions, forums are there. If you want to conduct the online examinations, in whatever sort and in whatever form you want to conduct it, it can be conducted in different ways. So if you want to conduct an assessment or an examination, so we have a module called QS or a feature called QS, using which we will be able to conduct the online test. A glossary is something like as an index or a dictionary things we can write or we can prepare a dictionary kind of things. Like on if you are conducting one hour a session on a particular topic, what are the important words or what are the important keywords? So on those keywords we can just create some sort of a dictionary kind of things. So that can be done with the help of glossary. A journal also is something like to this one, our dialogue. It's again in which students can directly type into textbooks and something like that, like something called as a discussion thing. So label, lessons, all these what I can do is I can just instead of explaining these things, we can directly do the things. I think that would be better. I can directly show you how we are doing it and how it looks like. So resources, survey, workshops, all these are certain activities. Okay, I'll do one thing. Sir, all of you are having laptops or computers in front of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, okay. Actually, I have set up one demo server. So I can give you access to that server and we'll see how we can manage this. Okay. And before that, we have two things. Something like similar to our Google Calendar or Google Google Calendar, where we are keeping our events. So this Moodle will provide you a calendar in which you can add the events. Events could be anything. It can be an assignment, it could be an exam, or it could be a discussion, or it could be something, anything, whatever things you want to do, you just make it as an event, and which can be assigned to a calendar. A calendar module is there. In the you can choose one day, and in that day we can create an event. So this event will be displayed to the corresponding students or corresponding participants of that particular course. Whenever they are logging to that, these events will be displayed in their calendar. So it will something like as act as an reminder also. So this is a very important or a very good one of the best feature of this one Moodle calendar and events. And obviously, as a teaching learning process, this grading is very important. So when we are conducting the exams or when we are giving assignments or when we are giving the quizzes or discussions and all, each and everything we have to set up or we have to award different marks to the students, right? So for a particular course, for a semester, say for example, for a semester we are conducting, during that semester we are conducting some, say 2-3 assignments, maybe there are some discussion forums, there may be some exam, multiple exam like exams. So how we are calculating the internal marks, say for example, by considering all these things, we have to calculate the internal marks and all, right? So whenever you are creating these assignments or quizzes and all, in each and everywhere we can give different sorts of grades. Okay, and in what all weightage you want to give for that particular, say for example, like for an exam, okay, we can give say 20% of weight or 20% weightage for that exam, say another 20% for assignment, some 10% for some other activity like that. We can create that kind of grading also. So at the end of the course, once we finish the course, it's very easy to create and or export the grade or the result for the entire class or the entire participants, which can be exported to an Excel file or PDF format. In whatever format you want, it is exported and we can directly get the entire mark for the class. So such kind of things can be done using grades. And obviously there are logs and reports to track the activities of each student or any participant. So each and everything will be recorded and all of them can be available in the log files. Okay, so this will be looks like. Okay, so sir, how many of you are using Linux systems?
Sir, I think most of the people may not be using Linux system. That's what I understand.
No issue. Like if there is anybody who is using a Linux system,
I think people from
yes,
computer science are there. One, two or three people are there.
Okay. So, if you're using a Linux system, to you have to make two changes in one of the file. So can you see this slide presently?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
You have to make this change into this file. So in your Linux system, there is a /etc/host file. So you have to make an entry into that server, because this is the server where I kept my Moodle server. I hope I'm clear.
Okay, sir. It seems that most of the people are not using a Linux system. Very few are there.
Okay. I'll do one. I'll take the next slide. This is for Windows users. Those who are using this Windows, can you make this change? Just press your window key on your keyboard, type notepad there, and don't open the notepad directly. When it shows notepad, give a right click and open or run it as administrator, because this /etc/host file is a system file, and what you are going to do is you are going to make a change that system file. So you have to run it as an administrator, otherwise you are not able to provide, or you are not able to make any change to that file.
Binish sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have a? Are you having a Windows system over there? Can you show your share your screen?
Actually, my system is Linux system. It's a Linux system.
Okay.
If you want, I have to reboot my machine so that I can. Do you want me to log into in Windows machine?
Excuse me, sir. This command has to be typed on Notepad.
Yeah. Command in the sense, you have to. What you have to do is, first you have to open the Notepad in administrator mode.
Okay, sir.
Then open the file in Windows C folder, Windows System 32 drivers. It is okay, sir. One minute, sir. Sir,
reboot your system and log in with Windows.
Yeah. I'll do one thing. Give me 2-3 minutes. Let me boot in Windows so that I can directly show you.
Yes, sure.
That will be better, sir, because most of the people are having Windows.
Okay, fine.
Once you show them, then it will be easier. Okay.
Fine. Okay, now I'm leaving the meeting and I'm okay. I'll reboot my machine. Okay. Thank you.
the meantime, let me ask one or two things. How many of the faculty members are having LMS system, or are there anyone who doesn't have an LMS system working in their organization? Just like Moodle or something else, like ET Lab or anything like that.
We don't have any.
We don't have, sir.
You don't have any. You don't have. John sir doesn't have. Sushma madam doesn't have. Are there any other people who are like that, who doesn't have a system? We don't have. Gautam Naskar sir is also telling. Okay. Who else is there? Yeah. Oh, Amay sir is also telling that they don't have. Okay, I think for such people, this is the easiest. Dhanlakshmi madam is also telling we don't have. This is the easiest way. Only thing is that you'll have to. Jayashree ma'am, tell me.
Yeah, in our institution we have, sir, but actually it is an open source software, no? So our system in charge and the system faculty are customizing our needs, and they have created a different version of it. But it is also called a Moodle only.
It must be Moodle itself. They might have customized it.
They have done a lot of customization. Yeah.
They might have. Customization is possible in this. So they might have done customization, enough customization. Yes, so that means you have a system. You have a Moodle system.
So that is the
type
of cake.
I am using it for the last 8 years.
Okay. Binish sir came back. Sir, Windows is okay?
Yeah, Windows is okay. Now I mean,
then you come to presentation mode, sir, please.
Yeah, sure.
When lot of people are following you, that's the issue. Okay. People with Windows machine.
So can you see this now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Clear. Very clear.
Yeah. Okay, this is what I asked you to do. Okay. So what you can do is you can press this Windows, type Notepad. I think it is visible, right?
Yes, it is.
Yes,
sir. It is visible, sir.
Yeah.
Visible.
Now can you see this run as administrator?
Okay.
You run this Notepad as admin, I mean,
with yes,
administrator
sir.
Privilege. Now what you can do is you have to open this file. Can you see here? C Windows System 32 drivers etc host. Can you see? I'll do this one. File, open. My C drives, Windows. You can see one System 32 folder here. Here you can see System 32. There is one more folder called drivers. Here you can see this etc. Now we are not able to see anything, right? Just make this. This is text document. You just make it as all files. Now you can see one file here, right? Host. Open this. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, do I need to repeat?
So, how did you open that host file?
I'll start it from. Once again. So you just press your Windows button and type Notepad. Okay. Now run as administrator. So this Notepad will be open. Now go to File and Open. Okay. In this, what you have to do is go to C drive, Windows. In bottom of this, we will be having a System 32 directory. In this System 32, we have another directory called driver. This drivers In drivers, we have etc, and this is, you just make this as all files, and you can see host file here, right? Is it okay now?
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now you just open this file. So it will be something like this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now what you have to do is you have to make an entry here. 14.139.171.184, and I'm giving it as a name as mccmodule.com. Actually, I am running my server, this Moodle server, on this particular IP. 14.139.171.184 is the IP address, or the address of the server where I am running my Moodle server. Okay, why I am making this change is I want to make your computer accessible to this particular server, because I did it for another organization and they did not made it public. So this mccmodule.com, it's not available in public network. That's why you are making this change in your configuration file. Now you can save this.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah,
it's a mcmodd or MODL.
Sorry, MODD.
MCC.
Yeah, mccmodule.com.
Okay.
Save this. Once you save this, you can close this. Now, what you can do is you can take this one and you can run CMD terminal. Command prompt, or if you are using your Windows 10 machine, we will be having another called PowerShell. You can use any of this, either a command prompt or a PowerShell, and you can type ping mccmodule.com. Okay, one second.
Sir, could not see what is there in the yellow font.
One second.
I think, sir, in host file, start with hash.
No. This host file, when you are starting with the hash, it is a comment. It is a comment. That file, that line won't execute.
Okay.
Sorry, sir, a small change in this one. Actually, it is not 171.184. One second, sir. A small change. It is 181.174. Sorry. Sorry. One second, sir.
Okay.
This is one 181, sorry, this is 181.174.
Exchange digit with 7 and 8, right?
Two digits exchange, they say that.
So it will save as like text file?
No, don't save it as text file.
So by default it is taking as text file. How to do that?
Yeah, you can, what you can do is you can just, in the bottom of that you can see now, that all file format.
So doing, but still it is accepting as a text file.
No, you don't. One second.
Please save, select the save option only, not save as.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sure, ma'am.
So I don't know what happened to the server. Okay, I got it. So this is the entry. I got wrong. First one was the right one. Okay, this is 14.131.171.184. You just make sure that this is the IP address which you have given. It's 14.139.171.184 space mccmoodle.com. Okay. Now what I did is I'm accessing mccmoodle.com from my web browser. Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm logging in as an admin for this. I'll give you the username and password through which you can log in. Okay. So your Moodle server will be somehow looks like this. So you can customize this. You can see a lot of themes and a lot of admin. What is the type of customization is available? You can customize this Moodle server as we wish. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is this is going to be the admin page where you can see this is the site administration in which you can do all the configurations. So I am not going to do any complicated configurations. What I did is I'll just make this users list. Okay, we can see the users. So I just created some five users, three student users and two teacher users. Okay. For the we have a student 3, student 4 and student 5. And for all the students, student 1, student 2, student 3, passwords are pass@123. pass@123, where P capital. Is it okay? We have three student users.
Sir, not able to open.
Not audible?
Not able to open, sir. Your server is not open, sir, on our platform.
Okay.
Parvati, ma'am.
Not able to open in the browser?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. Not able to open, sir.
Okay. What are you getting while you are trying?
404 not found error.
Okay. Can you just read
requested URL was not found on this server.
No, no. What is the URL that you have given?
mccmoodle.com/moodle/any.
No. Till Moodle.
Yes, sir. Got it. It opened.
Okay. Just give till Moodle.
Yeah.
No need to give anything else.
So in the browser, we should do it, is it, sir?
Sorry?
Should I open it in the browser, sir?
Yeah.
mccmoodle.com.
Okay. And just give mccmoodle.com/moodle. Okay. That also you give till this.
So username and password?
Yeah, I'm sharing the username. We have three student users.
Oh yes, got it, sir. Thank you.
Student 3. Student 4. Student 5. Okay. For all these, password is capital PASS@123. We have two teacher users. Teacher 1 and teacher 2. The password given is okay.
Can we have two dashboards open in the same system? Means that can I open browser?
Yeah, no problem. You can open it and you can log into that. No issue.
Okay, so in one can I log in as teacher and in another as student? Is that?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, the only thing is you have to use two browsers. In two tabs it is not possible. But if you are using two different browsers, you can use it.
One in Chrome, one is Firefox.
Yeah, right. It's possible.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Or if you are not having two browsers in your machine, what you can do is one you can use in your normal browser, and in second one you can browse in a private browser. Now, like when you are using, say something like this. Say this is sorry. This is my browser, and here I'll get an option called new private window, right? In your machine, if you are having only one browser, if you are having either Google Chrome or Firefox browser only, what you can do is you can open that browser. In one browser, you can use or you can log in as a student. And if you want to open the second one, you can come here. This is the option, this one. Here you can go for a private window. I'm opening here. So MCC. Now I am logging as a teacher. Teacher one. And now I log in as teacher. At the same time, same this browser, I admitted as admin. Okay, now this is the user side. What we are going to do is, see, now onwards, what I am going to tell is, as a teacher, it is not your duty. It is the duty of the administrator who has to create the courses. Okay, here you can see when you are using the site administration, you can see the courses. When you are using the courses, what you have to do is, say for example, if you're an engineering college, okay. So for example, what I have to do is, I have to create the categories. I hope you can see here, right? This I did for MCG, where they are running two courses. BSc MRP course is there and BSc Nursing course is there. They are running two courses. Okay. So what you have to do is, for example, in my college, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a beta course. So for that, what I'm going to do is, I have to create a category. For that, I am going to create a category, and on top of this one, BTech. Okay. Not doing anything extra, just create a category. Now I got a BTech as one of my course. Now I want, in this BTech, I have say for example, two disciplines. One is civil engineering, one is computer science engineering. So what we are going to do is, I'm going to make two categories, create a new category under this BTech, okay, civil engineering CSE. Okay, I hope you understood what I'm doing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so this is the course. Okay. Now, in my college, I have beta course. In that beta course, I have two disciplines. One is civil engineering, and second one is computer science engineering. Okay. Now, in computer science engineering or civil engineering, anywhere, you have to create. You have 8 semesters, right? So, create 8 new categories. So, this is something called, say, SEM 1. I'm creating as another category. SEM 2. So all these are for semesters. So now I hope you got the flow. Now what we are doing? See, we have 3 courses altogether. We have a BSc MRP course, we have a BSc Nursing course, we have BTech course. Okay. In BTech course, we have 2 disciplines. One is civil engineering, second one is computer science engineering. And in computer science engineering, we have semester 1 and semester 2. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to prepare this module for conducting the semester 1 courses. Okay. Now, I'm choosing semester 1. Now, you're creating the course. This course, in the sense, this is going to be your subject. So, okay, in computer science, we have basic computer science. Okay. Paper 1. Now what we have to do is, this is for BTech course. In BTech, it is for computer science. And again, it's for semester 1. Now, the most important thing is, when I'm creating this subject or when I'm creating this course, you have to clearly mention when your course is going to start and when it is going to end. The duration of the course has to be set very clearly. I hope I'm clear. Sir, are you able to follow?
Yes, sir, but I had a single doubt before we move forward.
Okay. You know, we can I just want to create one paper. Okay, let me do it like this only. I'm not doing anything extra. Now I'm save and return. Okay, paper 1-1.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, Moodle is directly available just with the whatever the URL we did the changes in the system 32 now.
Yeah.
File. That is the URL for the server, right?
Yeah. Why I asked you to change the change in your system 32 file is actually you can see this mccmoodle.com, right? This is a server name.
So if we have to use it for our colleges, we should be setting up our own servers, right?
Yeah, you have to set up your own server. This one is a demo server, and I installed this or I configured the server for another organization.
Okay.
Now what I'm doing is there's an organization called MCC Malabar Cancer Center in Thalassery. I made the server for them, and that's why mccmoodle.com.
Sir, can you show us how to set up the server also?
Yeah, I can show you, but the only thing is as we discussed it with sir told that we have interdisciplinary participants here. So it's setting up of this Moodle is pure technical. If you are not able to follow this technical technical know-hows, it is very difficult to set up. What I can do is I can give you one thing. If you really want to set up a server in your institute, I can give you my contact details. I'll share my mail IDs as well as my phone number. You just contact me. I can help you.
Thank you so much. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Does it have
any payment, sir?
Sorry.
For setting up the server, does it include any payment?
Any?
Payment, money.
So that we can discuss, man. It's not a very important thing. Like for me, it is not money. Money doesn't matter much. I'll help you to set it up. Don't worry.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now I made this course here. Now you can see here. You can just directly go to course. Now basic computer science. You can see this course. Okay. Now I am opening this course, and as participants, I am going to enroll my users. I want to assign a teacher. Okay. I am assigning. Teacher 1 and teacher 2 as teachers of this course, and student 5, 4, and 3 as the users of this course. Okay. Now what you can do is you can log into this machine either as a student or a teacher. Now you can log in as a teacher or a student. Now I am accessing as a teacher. Now this is my page. I logged in as teacher. Okay. Now you can see here when I am in my courses. Okay. You can see basic computer science. Okay. This is my course. So now I logged in as a teacher. Okay. Now you can see, can you see one flywheel here? Just click on this. You can see turn editing on option here. Now this is going to be the basic structure. So if you want to give a common announcement to the entire class, if you want to give some notice to the students or something like that, if you want to do, you can just do it in this as announcement. You can just give. If you have some, additional files or some more details about this announcement and all, you can just put it here. Now I just publishing it. Now, so it's available here. So announcement will be available. Now I am opening one more window. In another browser, I'll take. Here I'm logging as a student. I'm logging as PUD3. Now I'll logging as a student. Now you can see in my here I can see two courses. So this is basic computer science course. So I can see this announcement here. When I am clicking, I can open this. So this is visible for the entire class. If you are having some 100 participants or 60 or 100 participants, so this notice will be available for or visible for all. Now what I am going to do is I am going to do an activity. Okay, so I have some, like if I have some presentations, what I can do is I can add an activity. I have some file. My presentation. Save and return to the course. Now you can see, right? See, this is my presentation. Okay, I uploaded one presentation here. So what the student can do is we can see the other one. See, when student logged in, see, student can see the presentation. So this whatever things I am uploading here, this will be available to the students. So if you want to prepare, like when you are preparing the classes or when we are prepare our lectures, we have our presentations, this PowerPoint presentation. This can be anything, need not be PowerPoint. It can be PDF, it can be audio file, it can be video file, anything. Whatever thing you want to share with your students can be uploaded here. I'm not opening it, it's the same presentation. So it is available for the student, okay? So when we are doing, so all the activities, all the resources, you can see here when you are adding this resource, if you have an ebook, the entire ebook can be uploaded here. If you have for that relevant topics, if the ebooks are available, what you can do is you can just upload the ebook. So if you are having this as the same way which I uploaded these presentations, I can upload file. And even if you want to upload like all the resources for a particular topic, if you are arranged or you stored it in a file, So what you can do is you can if you're arranged it in a folder, if you want, you can upload that folder completely to this one. Or if you have some reference, external side reference, if you're having, you can just put it as a URL. So whatever resource you are having, I mean, like whatever resource that we are have, I mean, available for you for that particular relevant topic can be added to this area. Okay. So the same thing, what we can do is this, you can see one more setup here, edit settings. Now, okay, before this, you can just see here, we are arranging these classes or these courses in topic format, right? So first topic I am here, I mean, enter here, all the details I am putting it in as a block. In if it is ever, I mean, regarding me or if it is related with this topic too, everything I am putting here. Okay. Now I have another option here. So I'm settings. You can see a course format here. So instead of topic format, I prefer to have a weekly format. Now, can you see? See, earlier this was topic one, topic two, like that. Now what I change is because we have set up the opening day and closing day of the course. When we are designing this course or when we are opening this course, we have set up the course start date as well as the end date. Okay. Now, for each and every week, what are topics you are going to present? Everything can be arranged accordingly. This will help you to give you a total, a plan, a time-based plan, or in this particular week, if I'm planning to take these topics. So in that way, you can design on or divide the entire topics or the entire syllabus in such a way that so the topics are going to be covered in particular week will be arranged accordingly. Okay, so we have two basic formats. One is topic format and this is known as the weekly format. So both are available in this one, in edit settings. You can directly go to this one and you can change to topic format. Once again, so that I will this. Okay, now I have given a presentation. Now, based on this presentation, I want to conduct an assignment. Now, again, go to this add activity. So here you can see an assignment. I'm adding an assignment. Okay. Now, assignment. So this is my first assignment. So what are the description about this assignment you can give here, and if you are having some related files or something like that, you can upload here. And this is important. Now allow submission from 8 to 15, because this assignment, you can design this assignment in such a way that, like, whenever the students are duration of the assignment, the submission period can be decided here. Okay, if you're enabling this, you can set up here. Okay, now I'm going to start with on 8th, and now it is 15th. Now I'm giving only 2 days for their submission. Okay, so this assignment will start on 8th and due date is going to be 10th. Now we have two types of submission. One is online text and second one is file submission. Online text in the sense, students have to write their answers or they write their assignment as a part of the question itself. When it shows in, show the difference. Okay. Now, first I'll go with the file submission mode. Then, okay. If you want to set up a word limit, this is available only for this online text. So I can enable this. How many words you can give? So this one. Or if you want to, provide it both, you can use it. Now, maximum number of uploaded files, how many files they are supposed to upload. If you want to give multiple uploading, you can give here. Or if you want if you want them to upload a single file, just make it as one. so that this SME, for this assignment submission, they will be only having one, or they are supposed to upload a single file. Okay, and here comes accepted file types. In what all types file they can assign? Archive files, audio files, video files, HTML, image files. So better you give all files, or if you are supporting only PDF, you can choose PDF only. If you want to, if you want them to submit a JPG file, just choose the image file only. If you want to make it as document file, you can expand it. You can choose this one. If you want to permit only PDF file, just choose this PDF. That's okay. So file types you can choose, submission, and this is next thing is you have to decide the grade. How much mark you are going to give for this particular assignment? So this is maximum grade. If you want to make it as 10 marks for that assignment, just give maximum mark as 10. Okay, now I create an assignment. Now you can see first assignment. Now see how it looks like in student. See, for the student, it will be visible like this. So as a student, I am clicking on this first assignment. Add submission. I have to provide the assignment. I have to upload the assignment. So I can choose, once I finish my assignment preparation, make it as a PDF and upload here. This is how we are doing a file uploading. Now we will see the difference in the other one. Edit settings. Now I am going to change the file submission mode to online text submission mode. Now you can see the difference. Now go to student side. Canceling this. So this is when you add submission, you will get a text box where you have to write the assignment. I hope the difference between these two modes are clear. One is online text mode, means you have to enter whatever assignment or whatever things you are supposed to finish. Each and everything has to be written, you have to write it here and you can save it. Otherwise, the other way is you have to prepare your assignment in another file and you have to upload that file. In two formats, you can do the assignment. Now this is assignment. Now I have to add, I have to conduct an exam. Okay, that's the most important thing. So for that, what you have to do is you have to add a quiz as part of this is going to my first exam. This is an online examination. Okay, now I am creating, and you can set up the timing when this examination will be available. As we did in the assignment, you can enable this too. So this quiz will be available from 8 to 9, or like now it is 7:11, and if you want to make it to till till 9 o'clock, 2 hours. If I'm keeping this, I'll just make it as 21. Okay, now here we have to set up the grade to pass. How much mark we need to, minimum marks to pass. Okay, I'll give it 5 marks. So creating this one. Now QC is ready. Now what you have to do is edit quiz. You can see now in this quiz we don't have any questions, right? So you can see one add here. So we have two options. Okay, one is we can create a new question as a new one, or if you set up a question bank already, you can choose the question from that also. Now I'm adding a new question. Okay, Now when I'm adding a question, you can have different kinds of questions. You can have multiple choice, you can have true or false, you can have matching, you have short answer questions, numerical questions, essay questions, calculations. So different types, almost all sorts of questions will be, all question formats are available here. So when we are designing or when we are adding these questions, so this can be, you have to choose this. Now I'm going to choose one multiple choice. I'm adding it. Okay. I'm going to add my first question. So this is my first question. This is a multiple choice question. In that way, you will be having different options here. Okay, choice one, choice two, choice three, choice four, choice five, like that. Multiple choices we have. Now I am going to give my answer. So this is going to my answer one. This is answer two. Answer three, like that. And now the important thing is, when you are giving the choices, you have to set up, you have to clearly mention what is going to be the right answer. Okay. For this example, assume that this is choice 2 or answer 2 is the right answer. Now what you have to do is, you can see grade is equal to none here, right? Now you have to choose it as 100%. That means whenever you are choosing the second answer, you are going to get the full grade. Okay, and for all the other, we are setting it up none. Okay, I'm not setting any marks for the other options. And in the examination, if you want to set up the negative marks, you can set up negative marks here. Instead of 100%, you can go for -100%. That means if you are choosing a correct answer, you will get, say for example, if you are getting one mark, if you are choosing a wrong answer, you will get a -1, that is -100%. So if you want to set a minus marks, you can put this minus option, or otherwise you just kept it as none. That means there won't be any minus mark for the wrong answer. Okay. Now I'm save changes. So now my first question is ready. Now I'm going to add one more question. So instead of multiple choice, I'm going to give a true false question. So here, correct answer you have to choose. You have to tell that whether this is true or false. If it is true, you have to set it as this one as true, or else you keep it as false. Okay, I'm making this true. I'm saving this. Now I added two questions in this. Okay. Now I'm saving this. Now log into student. Now this is the student. Now here you can see the exam. Now see attempt to quiz. Now attempt to. Okay. See, this is my first question. One thing you can see here, the answers are shuffled. Actually, this answer one, when we are setting up the question, I put this answer one as my first option, answer two as my second option, answer three as my third option, right? Now what we did is, we have provision in this one in which it will automatically shuffle the answers also. So even if two students, they are sitting nearby, if they got the same questions, their answer options will be different. So if these two students got the same question as the first question, for the first students, maybe, see, I think we set the answer 2 as the right answer. In that case, for this first student, this is going to be answer 2, right? Maybe if you're instead of student 3, you may get this answer 2 somewhere in B or maybe in A. So there's an internal shuffling, okay? Now I'm setting up this as answer 1. Now this is true. No, I set it as false. Okay, now I finish attempt. Submit all and finish. Now I attempt this. Now you see, I got 2 answers wrong. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm logging out from student 3, logging as student 4. Now he is going to attempt the quiz now. See, earlier this answer 2 was as choice C here, now it is 2. Now I am creating this one. See, for a student 4, both the answers are right. Okay, now 2 students attend the quiz. Now you can see, as a teacher, attempts 2. See, this is the result. For student 3, he got 0 marks, whereas for student 4, he got full 10 out of 10. Because we set grade marks as 5. So 5 mark for this and 5 mark for this. So if you want this kind of all the graphical representation, everything will be available here. So we can do one thing. Those who wants to work on this one, like this creating this assignments or topics or something like this, if you want, you can just, or should I continue, or are you trying to do this?
So please continue and show us all the features. Because okay, we have the videos, we can do it a little later also. But
okay,
we
fine. Like to see fine. All the okay, fine, fine. Okay, now, okay. This is how you want. Okay, one more thing I can show you. I'll create one more activity, same activity in this quiz itself. And this is going to be one of the most important thing or most important feature of this module. This is my second quiz. So I'm creating this. So now this one, earlier I added questions directly. Now I'm going to create a question bank. Okay. Now this is going to be a question bank. Add selected. Now 2 questions I'm going to add into question bank. Now this is a question bank and I can add more questions.
Sir, please look in the messages, sir. So they are asking for shuffling the questions and all those things, options and all.
Yeah.
Vinesh, sir.
Yeah. I okay. Since
the message, please see this, sir.
Yeah. One second. Yeah, yes, these questions are, these options are there. You can shuffle the questions within a quiz. You can shuffle the questions as well as the answers. Both are possible. No issues. See, there is one option called shuffle, right? Can you see this one? Can you see this option? When we are adding these questions, we have an option called shuffle here. If you are clicking this shuffle here, okay, we will see the result. Okay, I am saving this. Now this is this is the second quiz. I'm attending the quiz. Okay, first I got the third question. Now I got the first question. And last I got the second question. Okay, this is submit all and finish. I'm submitting it. Now I'm logging as as the fifth student. Here again, here comes second question. Earlier this was the first question. So this shuffling option is working. It's working. There is no issue. So this option will work without any problem. And here also you can see. In first option or before this is for questions. These shuffle open options are for questions. If you are adding some, say, or 10 or 50 or 100 or questions here, what you can do is, like, you can shuffle the, if you are putting a tick over here, that the questions will be shuffled in this one. Inside the questions, here we can see one shuffle options. If you are putting this shuffle, answers also will be shuffled. That means two types of shuffling are there. Questions will be shuffled as well as answers of the questions. Both are. Okay.
Sir, one more thing, sir.
Sir, one second, sir.
AB here.
Yeah.
Sir, AB here, sir. Vinay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, what about the sessional marks? You know, will you be able to calculate the sessional marks putting all these things together?
Yeah, that is what, sir. That's what I said. I'll just show it to you.
Okay, sir.
Okay, this is teacher one. Okay, sir. Yeah.
Sir, in between, please look in that questions also, sir.
Some
pertinent questions have come up.
Sorry, sir.
Some in message, you know, questions are there.
Okay, I see what happens is when I'm doing this presentation, I cannot see the that meet link.
That what. I know that, sir. Recently, I'm just, you know, reminding you.
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll do it, sir.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Here, what we can do is we can just go to these grades. You can see one option here, right? Export. See, when you are exporting this first assignment, first exam, second quiz, course total, export format, you can download it. Select all. Sir, Dev, sir?
Yes, seeing, sir.
Okay. So, similar way, like when you are doing this, all these things, I just made it on one topic only. So what you can do is when you are doing the entire course, so whatever assignments, whatever cues, whatever activity you are giving, all those activities will be listed like this. Okay. So for the for the entire class, you can take a report and you can export it like this way. You will be getting this export option here. You just export it and it will give you the entire thing. So whatever for each and every activity, whatever mark that particular student got, everything will be, it will be displayed and in Excel format you will get this. I mean, when you are exporting it, you will get it in an Excel format so that it will be very easy for you to calculate the, what do you call that, the internal marks or sessional marks, whatever things.
Okay.
So let me check the this one, sir. Questions for a moment.
Questions. A lot of questions are there, sir.
Yeah. One question is, please send the IP address of the Moodle for this Moodle. See, one thing is this Moodle belongs to another organization. For them, I set up this one, and I took the permissions for giving this training. Like for if you want to work on this, you can practice it for 1 or 2 days, because for 1 week we are keeping it is for the training. So for the next 1 week, if you want to practice on this like creating these courses or creating this this kind of what you call this topics and or the activities, you can do it for next 1 week. After that, this access to this particular site won't be available. Is any limitation with the data size of the files or data on this platform?
In the mass?
Sir?
Hello?
Sir?
Hello, ma'am? No, ma'am, now it's reachable. Hello?
Actually, one question, one Dr. Sanjay Singh, sir, is any limitations with the data size of these files or data on this platform? Sir, actually, there is no that such kind of limitations. If your server is capable of holding large size of data, then you can set it up. But as a default, we are set up as 2 MP as the maximum size for one file. And I'm repeating, that is not the limit. So it is just to keep a limit. So what you can do is we have a configuration file called the php.ini file is there. In that, a default size is set as 2 MP. If you are marking, like if your server is having enough space, if you are having enough bandwidth, what you can do is just change that 2 MP to 10 MP or 100 MP or even 1 G. It is not a problem. So whatever be the size you want, you can set it up. I mean you can configure it accordingly. Only thing is your server should have that much capacity for both storage and that bandwidth capacity also. Can teacher edit assignment and resend to student? Obviously it's possible. So it's teacher is going to be the author or the what you call the owner of that particular subject or a course. So he can do, I mean, he can assignment, edit the assignment, and if you want, if the teacher can ask the student to resubmit it also, that is also possible. So is there an option to shuffle the questions? I think there I had already discussed. Data size, I hope, I think that also we discussed. Sir, can we import question from other format to this? Okay, that is also for that is also possible. Add questions one by one like this. In this presentation, we have the percentage. Okay, in this presentation, you can see somewhere. See this one. This is basically a text file. What you can do is you can upload if you have some 10 or 100 or say 1,000 of questions. If you want to set it up as a question bank, what you can do is you need not do it independently. What you can do is for example, if you are having say 100 questions with you, what you can do is you can just make it as a single file and make it as a single text file. But when you are doing it in text file format, there is certain syntax. You have to follow that syntax. Then you can write all your questions in that file, and we can import those questions from that text file or in that format. It's not an issue. You need not enter one by one level like that. If you have multiple questions, you have all those questions are you are keeping it in a file. It can be uploaded as part of the question bank. So can we give a percentage weightage to this SM? Obviously it's possible. That's what that grade option. When you are choosing that grade option, you will get permission, or you have facilities to provide the weightages. It is there. What is the minimum server requirement, sir? For running the server, two things you have to be taken care of. One thing is you should have a server space of 2 GB plus minimum, and you should have a minimum 2 Mbps of bandwidth, and you should have minimum 4 GB of RAM. That is the least or the minimum server requirement. Processor could be anything, even dual core processor machine will run this, no issue. Only thing is you should have enough bandwidth, and it would be better if you are depends on the clients. If you want to with 4 GB, 2 GB and 2 Mbps bandwidth, you can serve some 10 to 20 students together. For an institute and all, I think it would be better if you are having some 25 GB of space as well as 8 GB of RAM and 10 Mbps of data speed. So that would be enough for some 100 to 50 students. And we had pictures. This is also possible, as I told you, when we are setting up of these questions. Or when you set, set up the topics or related or relevant topics. So in whatever format it is, need not be not only the pictures. You can have picture files, you can have PDF file, you can have audio files, you can have video files on all the kinds of data format it supports. This is also possible. This we can import questions. Diagram also. Yeah, this also, it's also possible. It's a configure model on cloud. It is also possible, sir. This no issue to configure this in cloud. Need not be in a standalone server. What you can do is you can obtain some cloud space and you can configure it. If you want, I can share, at present I don't have it with me. If you want, I can share you the configuration, setup files also, how to configure this Moodle. That's also a step-by-step procedure is there. If you want to try, I can share that that details also with you. No issue. Ramesh Kumar Dank, I didn't get your this question. Please see my config on my PC. I don't understand what do you mean by this.
Sir, I have already configured this things.
Okay, fine.
Let me see the configuration with the Jump server.
Is it working fine, sir? Is there an issue?
Me working fine, but we have two Jump server right now.
Sorry, sir, I can hear you properly, sir.
Sir, I have two, one for the Moodle's Jump server, and another Jump server is running on my PC.
Okay.
Can we combine those two in a single?
Yes, it's possible, sir. It's possible. Only thing is at background, whether it is Moodle or something, whatever it is, what we are running is a basic web server, right? Apache web server we are running on backside, background.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, on same machine, what only thing is in the Apache configuration file, you have to add some virtual host. And you have to keep two separate server ports for two services. Like if you want to run two websites on same server, you have to set up two virtual host in that Apache configuration, as well as you have to set up separate port also. You have to assign one port for one server and second port for the second server. So the Apache server should be one. It's possible, sir. No issue.
Hello,
sir.
Sir, can I ask a doubt, sir?
Yes, sir. Please.
Sir, this Moodle's we have been using in our university also, sir.
Yeah.
But the one problem what I noticed with this Moodle's is, for example, if I log in at my place with my user ID and password.
Yeah.
The same user ID password can be used, and some other person can log in at some other place.
Oh, the problem is when they are configuring that Moodle server, there is one option, allow multiple users, allow multiple logins. One option is there in Moodle. Srinivas sir?
Sir, so when I need to disable that option, sir?
Yeah, you have to disable it. You have to disable that option so that it will permit only a single login.
Okay, sir. Is it possible at my end, or I need to take the help of the person who is actually working on this?
No, sir. It is not from your. It is not from your side. The server, the admin has to do it because it's a property of the server.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, sir. Thank you.
Minesh, sir.
Sir.
You had finished before time itself. You had finished somewhere, somewhere around 7:26 or something, you finished. And you were getting a lot of questions. Participants are very much interested. Okay. That is exactly the reason why this particular session has been included.
Okay,
because,
sir.
We know that it's a need. Sir, one pertinent question let me ask you. I'm not sure whether some people have asked a question.
Yeah.
But look, we are right now going into the attainment and all those things, right? Attainment.
Yeah.
What is it called? This, attainment? COPO attainment and all.
COP attainments, right.
COP attainments. Can that be tweaked into this Moodle system?
Sir, there is, in the new version of this Moodle, that outcome-based learning, right?
Yes, outcome-based, yes.
Yeah, outcome-based learning features are enabled in this Moodle now, but I did not explore it till now.
Okay, option is there, sir. And one more option
is there. The main problem with the Moodle what we are facing now is it is not an online platform for learning or for teaching process, similar to Google Meet or Zoom. Now one plugin is available as part of this Moodle. Using that plugin, we can incorporate this Google Meet as part of Moodle also.
Oh, actually, you can link the Moodle, Google Meet with the Moodle if you want.
Yeah, exactly. So in the similar way as we add the topics, right? So what you can do is we are creating this Google Meet link now. So we can put that Google Meet link as part of the Moodle itself, so that student can directly log into that Google Meet from this Moodle server itself.
Great,
it is a new feature and new plugin is available now for this particular server. Okay. I did not include that because I came to know that because
I only called you yesterday or the day before yesterday. Day before yesterday I called you, right, sir?
Yeah.
Only because in the first day itself, people were asking about Moodle. Participants were asking about Moodle, and I understood that most of the people are not having LMS system in their college. So that is actually the reason why I inquired with the Shamil sir, and Shamil sir gave you a number and all those things, and that's how I talked to you. Because initially I was thinking of showing our Moodle system, which is a paid thing. So, but in between I thought that, okay, fine, there can be people who may not be, because people from the government sector, they may not be able to pay for a learning management system. So in such cases, what to do? That is actually the reason where you have been called. And I think this session was really beautiful. And I hope that you will be sharing your number and number and email ID. So the participants can directly contact him and get the things done. And can you tell something, some rough idea of the cost involved? In the sense, you know, what type of server one has to procure? What will be the cost of that server?
Sir, actually for setting up of this server, this Moodle, we don't even need a server. If you are having a desktop with you, only thing is, for the desktop, what you need is minimum 8 GB RAM should be there. And 25 to 30 GB of server space also should be there. That's enough. You need not go for any special kind of server for this running this Moodle, sir. It's not required.
Okay.
You can configure it on any PC.
Okay. That means an ordinary system will be sufficient. Ordinary system which comes up right now, something like 30,000 rupees or maybe below 50,000 rupees is sufficient.
It's more than enough, sir. Only thing as I told you, the only thing is it should have a minimum of 8 GB RAM.
Most of the systems right now coming up are more than 8 GB RAM. That's what I understand.
Yes, sir. The only thing is if your system is having more RAM, your server server performance will be better.
Sir, Vinod Kumar is asking whether you require a public IP. Just see the inbox message.
Sir, we need a public IP. The only thing is, if you want to access this Moodle server from outside your institution or outside your organization, yes, you need a public IP. If you want to share as an inside resource or an intranet, you need not public IP. You need not a public IP.
But under this pandemic situation, I think it will be needed. Isn't it so, sir?
Yeah, this pandemic situations, if you're running this kind of online classes, online lectures and all, then you need a public IP.
Okay. Any more questions, sir? Any more questions from the participants? Professors? Now, the thing is that you have two options before you as far as in LMS is concerned. You might be knowing that, you know, higher education department as well as all the Council of Technical Education and all Pharmacy Council of India and all those people, as per the new education policy, they are actually looking towards or telling very clearly in their directives that you need to go into an LMS. So you have two options before you. Either you can set up a low-cost system or low-cost solution like what Sir has told. And the second solution will be, we will discuss about that second solution tomorrow morning, and that's a fully paid version that what we are using. So whatever is convenient for you, you can go and look at. Okay. One more question has come, sir. Please look into it. Any more questions? One more question, it seems. Do we have any more questions? Do we have any more questions? Do we have any more questions? Can we maintain repository of video lectures?
Yeah, excuse me, sir.
Please ask,
sir,
ma'am.
Sir, I don't have any functional related questions, but I have out of my curiosity, I want to understand how come it is open source available at free of cost for the entire universe, sir? What is the advantage that the company is getting out of it? I don't understand that.
That I think Minister will be able to explain. He's an open source, a hardcore open source person.
It's a very common common question. That's a very common question and very interesting question. Like how this open source sustains, or the people in the open source field sustain, right?
Yes, sir.
See, in the world there are a lot of people who are working on this open source. As part of their service, as part of a service, okay. Like apart from this, all the things in open, like in what you call this Linux or open source, it is not free. Only thing is source is available. That's enough. That doesn't mean that the entire things in the world or in the entire thing in the open source field is free. There are, something they are giving as totally free, and for some functionalities they are charging also. That is one thing.
Yeah, in terms of Moodle, what are the things that they are charging, sir? We don't know.
Like for going for an organization, for your institution, you need not pay anything, ma'am.
Okay.
The entire source code is available. Only thing is you have to download that source code and you have to configure your own this server. That's it.
Okay. That's how our system admin is configuring and customizing according to our needs, right, sir?
Exactly.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
So the practice sessions, the people are asking practice sessions share the practice session password for practice session for 1 week. That's what most of the people are asking. Okay. Is there any other questions, or otherwise we'll have to close this session? Are there any other questions? We already are around 8 o'clock.
I just shared the user IDs for teacher login as well as student login.
Okay.
So some of them were asking for that. So teacher
yes, one. Yes, they were asking for that.
Yeah. Yes. I just shared it here.
And Minister has already told that if someone of you are interested in setting up systems, he can help you. Remotely he can help.
We can help them. We can help them. Or if they want to set up their own Moodle server, we can help. Obviously, we can help them. No issues.
Okay, that the process, you can directly call Vinay sir and get his help out of this, so that you will be in a position to be benefited. So as I have told before, you have two options. One is this easy option, and the other one is a little bit paid option. Sharmila madam, you are asking something, or I'll be wind it up. Okay, I think this was one of the beautiful sessions we had, and the participants have were asking a lot of questions, and I think a lot of people would like to have such type of a system or a module system installed in their in their college. Particularly, an LMS system is not available in most of the places. So if such places are there, then I think you can think or you can discuss with your higher officers and install or and incorporate such a system over there, so that it will be easier for your management of learning resources. So anyway, sir, Binesh sir, thank you so much. And I want to tell from my side, big thanks to you, because the day before yesterday only I asked you to arrange for this session, and I'm so happy that you have gracefully accepted this particular challenge, and you have I have asked for 1.5 hours only. You are here for 2 hours. 2 hours fully, completely you are interacting with the participants. And I find it, I'm very thankful about that. Yeah, thankful about your, about this particular session. And I thank Government Engineering College Kannur also for permitting you to attend such type of a training program. And I thank all the participants for your patient hearing and the support that you have given us till now. And I want to make one announcement. And the announcement is that for the test, the questions will be from the session till tomorrow. First session will not be in this session only. Questions will be asked. Only technical session questions will be included. Non-technical session questions will not be included. Tomorrow first one is a non-technical session. Non-technical session is then it will be a demo session only. So that will not be included as far as the questions are concerned. So we will be uploading all the in the YouTube channel. We'll be uploading all the all the recordings. So you please go through the recordings and get yourself acquainted with whatever has been discussed over here. So the questions will be based on that. Okay. So the test will be there in the last hour tomorrow. So tomorrow at 2 we'll be meeting. So 2 to 2:30 we'll be having we'll be having this paid LMS. That is the one that we are using here, which is supplied by Etua Systems, Kalo. So that we'll be having, you'll be having a familiarization session of that particular thing. So if you are in a position to pay for your LMS, then you can go to such type of people, pay sufficiently for your, because we did that because we had this TechUp and all those things. That's how we have gone into that. Most of the colleges who had TechUp have gone into that. And you can decide for yourself. We are giving two choices. That's the reason why you are putting these two choices over. And the second session will be, as per the requirement, it will be a spiritual session. A spiritual or counseling based session. So, and Dr. Isaac, I'm told that he's not feeling well. So, he may not be able to do that. And I'm getting another person for considering, for covering that particular session, because that session is mandatory as per other norms. That session is mandatory. So, and after that, the test will be there in the last session. That is the last session is starting from 6 to 7:30. So we'll be closing by tomorrow 7:30. So that will be the schedule for tomorrow. And thank you all once again, and a warm good night to all, and namaste from my side to all over here. Good night, good night, bye.
Good night, sir.
Good night, good night, good night, good night, good night. Exam timing that I've told you, it will be in the last session. It will be in the last session. It will be conducted in the last session. Last session will be having exams as well as validatory function. Okay, thank you all.